The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall, bellwether of this flock that assembles here to mull over the mysterious and the macabre. Doomsday is near, said Mr. Shakespeare. So, die all, die merrily. Or to put it another way, eat, drink, and be merry. For tomorrow... At any rate, since the very beginnings of the human race, we have had our prophets of doom. Our seers and sages who have thundered or whispered their awful predictions for a frightful finish that will overwhelm all of us.
And what are you called?
Gold.
Gold. A very revealing name. Your hair shines like gold.
What do I call you?
You will call me Mistress, because you are now my slave.
Do I have the right to know your name?
You have no rights at all.
As your slave, what am I supposed to do?
Mystery drama, The Children of Death, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Tony Roberts. It is sponsored in part by Luden's Medicated Cough Drops and Buick Motor Division. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Nobody knows how or why it all happened. And actually, it doesn't matter. All those people who argued about the end of everything, who warned, who threatened, who pleaded, those who hastened it, and those who tried to prevent it, all of them are gone. Long ago, they became dust. And long ago, that very dust has been blown into the skies and washed into the streams and the oceans. And who could ever find it today? For a few short millennia, they rule this earth with their great tools of metal and fire. But they couldn't rule themselves. And when they finally turned on each other, it was awful to behold. They might have created a heaven. Instead, they produced a hell. And it consumed them. And now, others walk this world.
My name is Gold. I am called Gold because my hair is yellow. It shines like that metal you can see shimmering sometimes in the stream. That metal, it's not really good for anything. You can't use it to edge or point a weapon. But it has such a bright and happy color. Like me. I'm not good for anything either. But I'm always bright. And I'm always happy. There are those who say that if I were not the son of the high priest... Well, it's true. I'm no good at hunting. Either animals or women. And I'm no good at reciting the law either.
Speak the first holy principle.
The first holy principle, woman
is the embodiment of all that is evil.
Oh, yes, Father. Now I remember.
Speak the second holy principle.
The second holy principle.
Birth and death.
birth and death.
She lives but to bear a child, and when he enters the world, she must leave it.
Oh, yes. Yes, that's right.
Gold.
Yes, Father.
You are my son. The only son of the high priest. One day you will be the high priest. You must be able to speak the ritual.
Yes, Father.
Now, repeat after me. The third holy principle, warm gold.
I must admit, I never could understand it. I never could see why we couldn't live at peace with the women. We were always raiding and killing and capturing them. And they were always raiding and killing and capturing us. And why? Didn't we need each other to make the children? I once said to my father, why can't we and the tribe of the women live at peace? And he looked at me, and I could see the storm gathering in his eyes, and he shouted,
blasphemy!
But, Father...
Silence!
I only want to know why.
All that you need to know is contained in the 10 holy principles.
But, Father, those principles don't tell me anything.
Sacrilege!
Father, it would seem to me that peace...
Perversion! Sound the signal drum!
Please, Father.
Build the fire!
No, Father.
Bind him to the stake!
Please, Father.
We must purify you!
No! I was purified. I was surrounded by leaping flames. And there's nothing like fire to teach a man wisdom. I became very wise that day. I mean, I learned that silence is the highest wisdom. And I never spoke about women, or war, or peace for a long time. Until the day my father sent for me.
Your time has arrived, Gold.
My time, Father?
The law says that you must also become a father. You are my only son. And you must take a woman.
Take a woman?
Take a woman. And have a son of your own.
You know me by now, Father. I couldn't capture a warrior woman.
You shall not disgrace me. Your time has come to capture a woman.
I'll be killed.
Then you will die in the embrace of the gods.
Why do we have to catch each other and kill each other?
This is the way it has always been. And this is the way it will always be.
And that was the answer I would always get. All morning would be spent in prayer to make sure my heart was pure. And all afternoon would be spent in sword fighting to make sure my hand was steady. And my teacher was the great hero of the tribe. An older man now, he had been the mightiest hunter of both animals and women. The mightiest hunter and the greatest killer. And that's why his name was Death.
Parry. That's it. Now I shall fight like a woman. Make use of your reach, your longer reach, to keep me outside. No. Never let a woman get close. No man is a match for their blinding speed. Keep her outside.
I'm sorry.
You should be. You'd either be dead or a prisoner.
I'm not very good at this.
I would say you're hopeless.
That's true.
Yes, you could be very good. You just don't care. Why is that, Gold?
Well, I don't believe in killing.
How is it possible for a man or a woman not to believe in killing? If we don't kill the women, they kill us. Now, you want to go out there and die?
No.
Pick up your sword and we'll start all over again.
What can happen to a man who refuses to capture a woman when his time comes?
The law says he has to be put to death.
Where could a man go?
What do you mean?
You traveled more than anyone else. We have this part of the forest, which belongs to the men. And beyond the mountainside, the forest which belongs to the women. What else is there?
Nothing.
That isn't true. There must be more.
There's nothing else. Nothing.
I'll go around the forest of the women. Toward the river we can see from the hilltop.
Gold. Don't do it.
Why not?
Because it's a haunted place.
Then you've been there.
Yes, I've been there.
Well, what's it like?
I don't know.
Yes, but you say you've been there.
I don't know how to describe it. There are stones.
Stones? What's so remarkable about stones?
They're very large. And they're placed one on top of another.
Why would anyone wish to place stones one on top of one another?
And other things, which I cannot describe, especially a thing that talks.
A thing that talks?
Yes. A thing in the shape of a square stone. Except that it is not a stone because it is very light to the touch.
And it talks.
It talks.
What does it say?
It's blasphemous, so I must not repeat.
Blasphemous? How?
It speaks of men and women. And both men and women speak from it.
How is it done?
I picked it up from the ground, and as I held it in my hand, something moved beneath my finger. And the voices seemed to pour forth from it.
But this is madness.
Ask your father.
My father?
He was there with me.
The high priest.
Ask him.
What is this place he speaks of, Father?
It could only be the place of our ancestors.
How do you know?
They were people like us. Men and women together. And that's why they were punished.
Punished? How?
Great flames destroyed their world.
Why?
Because they lived together in defiance of the gods.
How do you know this, Father? How?
They told us.
Who told you?
They did. Their voices spoke to us from the box that Death told you about. They said they were being punished for arrogance.
But
they were great people, mighty shapers of metal. They were wiser than we are in so many ways, except in one. They did not believe in the gods. They denied the gods. And you, my son.
Is that what they said?
And you, my son, do you not also deny the gods?
No longer, Father. No longer.
Then you will go to the land of the women. You will capture one and bring her home.
Yes, Father.
Then there is no longer any doubt?
No, Father.
Do you believe in the 10 holy principles?
Yes, Father.
Then go. Capture your woman, my son. I give you my blessing.
Well, the ultimate enemies, men and women. And in the primitive world of the future, and who is to say this is not our future, the combat is ceaseless and unrelenting. But here and there, we have the doubters, the questioners, the boat rockers, who ask unsettling questions. We'll have quite a bit of that when I return in just a few moments with Act Two. story has postulated a strange, savage world, far in the future, where combat is the order of the day, and the combatants are men and women. They capture each other, they use each other, and then they kill each other. And if you stop to think about it, actually, in a way, that's not too different from how things are right now. But why bother with truth when we can enjoy fiction?
And so, I was pronounced fit and ready to capture a woman. And the tribe held a great ritual celebration for me. There were prayers and dances. Mighty tales were told of great feats by heroes who had already captured many women. And finally, armed with my father's spear and sword, I was led to the edge of the forest, the Forbidden Forest, by my teacher and sponsor, Death.
Are you frightened, Gold?
No.
Say the truth.
Well, yes.
Remember what I taught you?
Yes, I remember.
They're very good fighters inside. Never let a woman get close enough to use her dagger.
I remember.
Oh. You won't remember. In the heat of the fight, you'll do what's in your heart.
I wish I knew what was in my heart.
Before this night is over, you may find out.
Slowly I walked away from him, and soon I was alone. All alone in the forest. I'd never been alone in my life. And now, I was all by myself. How frightening it is to be alone in the world. What was to become of me? Now I had to kill or be killed. Capture or be captured. I'd never done anything like this in all my life. And then I heard it. The sound of a spear striking the tree I was leaning against. It landed scarcely an inch away from my throat. The entire spear had buried itself in the trunk. The shaft was still quivering. A powerful arm had hurled that missile. And then I saw her standing some 30 feet away. She was tall, like me. Blonde, like me. She was wearing a shirt of fur, like me. And in her hand, she was holding the long, murderous, two-edged blade the women always carry.
I missed you on purpose. Throw down your spear if you dare.
Why? Why did you miss me?
I want a capture, not a kill. Will you fight?
Bad. Bad, very bad. No one ever said so out loud. No one would dare to admit it. But between us and the women, there was a kind of... Well, it was an understanding. If a man and a woman should encounter each other, and they felt they were evenly matched, they would pretend that they didn't meet and go their separate ways quietly. You only risked combat when you felt you could win. The fact that she had decided to challenge me was a bad sign. Why couldn't I have encountered a small, puny woman? This one appeared to be so alert, so capable. But what could I do? How could I refuse to fight? Besides, she looked as if she could outrun me.
You're not very good. I could have run you through. You should have learned to fight before you came out. This is too easy. Still, you're handsome. You should father a beautiful girl for me. But first, I must disarm you.
A prisoner. There was no escaping my fate. It would be useless to try to run away. We had met in combat, and the gods had decreed the winner. There was nothing to do now but submit.
What's your name?
Gold.
Gold. I see why. Poor gold. Bright, shiny. But so soft.
And what do they call you?
You will call me mistress, because you are now my slave.
Have I the right to know your name?
You have no rights at all.
Will you tell me your name?
My name is Flower.
Flower?
Oh, I see you're easily amused.
I don't know how it is among the women, but among us, a name describes a person. I'm like gold. My friend is a great killer. He's called Death. One who runs swiftly is named Deer.
It's the same with us.
You're hardly a flower. Am I your first captive?
Oh, no. And you won't be my last. I hope, for your sake, that you'll do better than the others.
What do you mean?
Oh, why do men talk so much? What does it matter? Come. We have a ceremony to perform.
I was taken to the village of the tribe of the women. And it was very much like the place of the men. Like the men, the women lived in tents made of fur. Like the men, the tent of the high priestess was larger and finer than all the rest. And like ourselves, they had built a huge stake in the center of the village. If they weren't women, and if I weren't a slave, I would have thought I was at home. I was taken before the high priestess. She was a tall, handsome woman.
You are?
Gold.
You are the son of
the high priest.
A good catch. I give you my blessing.
Well, that's a good sign.
What are you saying?
You're blessing me. That means...
That means I wish you to be the father of a girl who will bring glory to her people.
Oh. I had thought, perhaps, that you...
You? You are of no importance, no consequence. You are merely an instrument. And when you have performed your mission, you shall be cast aside.
You mean killed?
These things are the will of the gods. As the son of a high priest, you should know that better than anyone else.
I don't really know very much about it.
It is clear to me that you do not know very much about anything, including the most important thing of all.
What is that?
How not to get captured.
Well, here you are.
Yes, here I am.
I was looking for you.
Do you want me to come back to the tent?
Yes, we have a ritual to perform.
All right. It's such a beautiful night, though.
Beautiful? What do you mean by a beautiful night?
Well, look.
At what?
Well, at the stars. The moon.
We see those every night.
Yes. I suppose so.
And yet, every night you stare at them? As if you've never seen them before?
Every day. Every night. I look at the sun, trees, mountains, the streams, the moon, the stars, as if... And as if I'm seeing them for the very first time.
You do? Why?
Why?
Yes, why? What purpose does it serve? Wouldn't you have been better off to study sword fighting?
Better off?
Well, if you had, I might have been your prisoner and slave, instead of how it is now.
That's your good luck, isn't it?
It's the will of the gods.
What would you do if one day... You suddenly asked yourself, what if there were no God?
You shouldn't say that.
Why not?
Because you're very close to the next world. You know that, don't you?
Yes.
If I have a child, you'll die at the moment of its birth. If the child is a boy, it will be killed with you.
How would you feel about that?
Feel? These things are decided by the gods. And if by the time the first snow falls, there's no sign that I'm to have a child, you will be sacrificed to the gods in any event.
Then I might as well be happy while I can.
I don't think the gods want me to have a child.
No?
You're my... I have captured 5 slaves, and I've never... It's cold. There's a sudden chill in the air.
Winter is coming.
We should go back into the tent.
You sent for me, priestess.
The snow is on the ground, Gold.
I know that.
We will miss you.
You will...
I have never said anything like this before. How could I? To a man. But you... You are different. You make people smile.
I wish I knew why.
The gods. They made you different. They made you happy. Perhaps they should have realized this and protected you. Although I am not criticizing the immortal gods.
And since I believe I'm due to see them soon, I'll tell them that.
You must die 7 days after the first snow, since flower is still barren. Prepare yourself for death.
Prepare myself? What am I supposed to do to prepare myself?
I cannot understand such a question.
I would imagine that the best way to prepare yourself for death is to lead a long, full, happy life. What do you want me to do in a week?
You're a madman. Do what is sensible. Prudent people always do.
And what's that?
Pray.
Why? Do I have a chance to get the gods to change their minds?
Pray. That they will give you another life after this one. And that in time, you will be born again. But as a woman.
Gold? Gold, wake up.
What is it?
Gold, I want you to close your eyes and pray to the gods.
All right. But why?
Because I'm going to kill you.
You're going to kill me?
I don't know why.
Don't you have a reason?
Pray to the gods. To accept you in the other world.
I know I'm supposed to be killed.
Pray to be born again.
Yes, but the week isn't over.
Pray.
I believe I still have 2 days.
I could have killed you while you slept, but I wanted you to know why.
Well, I appreciate
that. You must know why, Gold. You must know why.
All right. Why?
It's because of the way I feel toward you.
How do you feel toward me?
I don't know. But I do know what I feel is wrong. Do you hate me?
No. No. I don't hate you.
Well, you should. I'm a woman, and you're a man. And the gods tell us that... You have cast a spell on me.
What do you mean? A spell?
I have a feeling that it is new. Tonight I looked up at the moon and the stars, and it was as if I was seeing them for the first time. Everything seems different and exciting and wonderful. What have you done to me, Gold?
I don't know.
I've gone mad, and the gods are punishing me.
For what?
For not hating you, for not wanting you to die. And so, to prove to the gods that I still obey and believe them, I must kill you myself, right here, now.
Flower, don't.
Whom the gods would destroy, they first make mad. And in this case, angry. Well, these sworn foes, these warrior men, these Amazon women of the far and distant future, how can they finally resolve their differences? Or can they ever? The scheduled time for all resolution is, as you know, the third act. which I shall bring you here in just a few moments. Does the future repeat the past? There are those sages who will insist the future is merely the past in another variation. Perhaps. It is said that in the dim and distant beginnings of the race, men and women vied for supremacy. As we know, the men won this time. But suppose there comes a time when the world has to begin all over again.
I must kill you.
Very well. Go ahead. Kill me. It'll be better. Quicker. Easier for me than the stake. Go ahead.
No.
Why?
I can't.
I want you to. I would rather.
I can't kill you. And that's all there is to it.
Is this flower talking? Flower? Blood red flower?
Something has happened to me. I'm frightened.
Frightened? Of what?
I don't know. I've never been frightened in all my life, and now you frighten me. Can you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
No, I don't think you do. I don't think you can.
But I do, because you frighten me, too.
Gold?
Yes.
What are we going to do?
Gold, this is the ritual we must perform on the eve of sacrifice. Are you ready?
Well,
we must recite the 10 holy principles. You know them, of course, since you are the son of a high priest.
I know ours. How would I know yours?
Repeat after me the first holy principle. Man is the embodiment of all that is evil.
Woman is the embodiment of all that is evil.
Do not blaspheme at this time and in this place.
But, priestess, that is what I was taught. Woman is...
I am speaking of the law. As it was revealed to our ancestors.
But I am only speaking the law that was revealed to our ancestors.
Repeat after me the second holy principle. Man but lives to give woman a child. And when she enters the world, he must leave it.
Woman lives but to bear a child. And when he enters...
Gold!
But this is how my father taught me...
Your father is in error.
Why?
The answer is evident. Your father is a man. Men are incapable of understanding the holy laws.
Why?
Because they have neither the intelligence nor the piety.
Are we talking about the same God?
The holy gods are the holy gods. They rule alone. There are no others.
I am sure that there is a misunderstanding somewhere.
I shall save you from yourself. I shall not permit you to insult a god further. And so, when you die tomorrow... They will accept you. Return to your tent.
I've had other slaves. All of them had to die. I never thought about it. It never bothered me.
The truth is, you've also cast a spell over me.
What's it like?
I don't know.
Oh, Gold, I wish... It's so fantastic. I don't think I could tell you.
Why not?
Because...
I feel that I could tell you anything.
The fact is, I'm a practical person. And no one who is alive today, either man or woman, ever heard the gods speak.
That's true.
And so... Since they spoke so long ago, we don't really know what they said. And we can never really find out unless...
Unless?
Unless they should choose to speak again.
Flower, listen. We can hear the gods speak.
How?
There's a place. Do you know it? It's called the place of our ancestors.
The forbidden place.
I know a man who... Who's been there?
And he wasn't struck dead?
No. And he said he had heard the voices of the ancestors.
How? It's been Oh, so many years since the ancestors perished.
He heard their voices.
How?
I don't know. He said the voices had been captured and placed in a thing.
Magic?
I don't know.
Well, what did the ancestors have to say?
He couldn't tell me.
Why?
Because he was afraid to listen. The ancestors, don't you see? The gods spoke to our ancestors. The ancestors, they can tell us what the gods said.
Let's ask them.
How can we? It's the forbidden place.
I'm not afraid. Are you?
But if we go, then you will be...
I know. I will be put to death. But they'll have to capture me first.
Flower, do you mean that you would die for me?
Yes.
Why?
I don't know.
I would die for you, too. And I don't know why, either. Are you afraid?
Yes, I am. The ancestors lived here.
It's the stones heaped one atop another so high.
These must be, what, tents?
The ancestors made tents of stone.
Yes, they'd be strong. One would be safe from attack.
Yes, but that didn't save our ancestors. They died anyway.
Why did they die, Gold? Why?
Inside one of these tents is a thing shaped like a square stone. Must be the snare that has captured the voices of the ancestors. We must find it.
And must we go inside the stone tents?
Don't be frightened, Flower.
I'm not frightened. As long as I'm with you.
That's how I feel.
What is this place?
I don't know. I can't even imagine.
Along the walls. Pictures, such as we try to draw on rocks with the juices of berries.
And such pictures.
These people. Our ancestors.
Look. Men and women. Together.
And children. Boys and girls.
What does this mean?
It means they sinned. And that's why they were destroyed.
No.
Why do you say no?
Well, look at their faces. See how happy they are. These are good people.
Yes, they were good people. Why did the gods destroy them?
I don't know. If only... Wait a minute. You see that? See that thing? It looks like a square stone on the ground.
Yes.
That's where the voices are.
How can we make it speak?
My friend said he picked it up, and something gave beneath his fingers, and the voices came out. So, let me see.
No, don't.
Why? Why
not? It might be blasphemy to touch it.
But it's why we came here.
Then, let us pick it up together.
Now.
Yes, I have this end.
It's light. So light.
Why doesn't it speak?
Because something is supposed to move.
Wait. Something has started. What's that?
The gods.
My name is David.
My name is Lorna.
Very soon now, we will have destroyed the world.
It's the gods. The gods speaking.
We had everything to live for. Every reason to be happy and prosperous.
All we had to do was love each other.
Why didn't we love each other?
Why did we hate each other?
Hate. Like an army of invading locusts that destroyed everything in its slow, deadly march across the world.
In the end, hatred became the universal measuring rod. Hatred. It drove us all mad.
And once we started to hate, we couldn't stop.
Those who were of different colors hated each other.
Those who lived in different places hated each other.
The young and the old hated each other.
And even men and women hated each other.
And the circle became smaller and smaller.
And finally, you had to hate everyone who wasn't you. But all God ever told us to do was love each other.
And we didn't do it.
We couldn't do it.
And so, we destroyed ourselves.
The bombers, the missiles, are now in the sky. I love you, David.
I love you, Lorna. And I pray that God will allow our words to live somehow. And that sometime, someone will listen.
We are the children of death.
May you who hear this always be the children of life.
I love you, David. What did she mean? What does it mean? Love.
I love you, Flower. I love you.
Oh! I love you, Gold.
The gods didn't destroy the ancestors.
The ancestors, they destroyed themselves.
Just as our people will destroy themselves. Flower, we must bring this box back to our tribes, yours and mine. We must say to the people, listen. Listen before it's too late.
But Gold, they'll only...
Only what?
Nothing. It doesn't matter. Gold, I love you.
And so they took what they could only imagine as a magic box back to their people. And now we're going to let you write the end to the story. Because what is the fate of the prophet who brings the word? Is he greeted with bread or a stone? Were they hailed because they were saviors? Or were they destroyed because they were saviors? Let your own hopes and your own visions, or your own doubts and your own fears, supply the final chapter. I'll be back shortly. Hate unleashed becomes the master. Or, he who rides a tiger dare not dismount. Put it any way you please. Hate is a fire that requires constant fuel. And sooner or later, he who hates must finally be consumed by the flames. Isn't it simpler to love? Of course it is. And we'd love to have you here 7 times each week. Our cast included Tony Roberts, Marion Seldes, Evie Jester, and Robert Dryden. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
Well, I'm the only one, the only guy down here, that's all. I'm fixing up the garage.
Well, just remember, dinner at 6 sharp. I don't want to miss any of my shows.
Who's that old bag?
That's my mother. No. You didn't say that.
You mean you don't like an old battle axe like that?
It isn't that. Oh, no. Now, on top of everything, I'll have to go to a psychiatrist. B could never live that down.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking for? You're a horse. Horses aren't supposed to talk.
Well, I ain't no ornery horse.
I don't believe it. I just do not believe it. Here I am talking to a horse. But worse than that, the horse is talking to me.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, Brewers of Budweiser, and True Value Hardware Stores. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.